Hiya Dishes, how is everyone? I am so sorry that I have not put out a video this week so far. I have been so busy planning my mama's 80th birthday party, and I'll tell you, you may already know this from watching me, but I am not a planner. So I've been stressing myself out and I haven't been able to put a video together, so I wanted to put something out for you. I've just been doing my quick little trips, running in the store for 15 minutes when I'm on my way to pick up my son, and I really haven't done too much, but I'll show you what I found, and yeah, we'll get to him. I was so happy to find him. So the Salvation Army is near my home and on my route to pick up my son from school, and I'll pop in there frequently. On this particular day, I found a few treasures. And the first one I want to start with is not these things that you see on the table, but this tablecloth. This is a vintage 1950s tablecloth. It's a nice large one. It's in excellent condition. There was one tiny little stain that I know that I can get out, but it doesn't bother me at all because I use all my tablecloths. In fact, many of them are starting to get holes. So it is a gray color, like I think it's showing up on the camera, and it has this kind of dogwood, I guess. I think that's what I would call it. Which I don't know if that's a spring or fall or what season that flower blooms, but I think this is a lovely tablecloth. I have it on my table here in the parlor, and I am very, very happy with it. It's that nice heavy cotton that just lays flat, and I'm going to show you the label. My lighting is so bad in here. I need to get one of those circle lights. Yeah. It is Willander, genuine Willander trademark. And I think that just says product. And these were all made in the USA. And you will not believe what I paid for it. I don't know, it's a rectangle. It's not square, it's a nice size, but I didn't measure it. But it'll fit a large table. This table seats six, and I have a little bit larger table in the dining room. But look, all right. As my son says, close your eyes and open your eyes, and you will get a big surprise. Look at that. Yes, indeed, it was $2.99. And you know what? I don't usually look at the linens there. I usually don't. Then I wanna show you this super cool vase I found. I kept picking it up. I know that I have windows everywhere, so it's gonna be hard not to get some kind of glare. It's not a huge vase. You can see my hand here, so maybe it's about 4 inches high. But look at this cool pattern on it. I don't know anything about pottery and glazes. So to me, I'm calling these dandelions. It looks like dandelions, and it goes all the way to the top. And it also looks like a, you know, like a, I don't wanna say crackle, but you know, like a cracked ice type of look with different color glazes underneath. Look at this cool green. I think it's so cool. And I haven't even taken the tags off anything. Look at that price, $1.99. Can you believe that? It's even glazed on the inside. I don't know how far down, but you can see that it's glazed around the lip. There is not a thing wrong with it. It says Brenda 83. Anyway, I was doing some, I was trying to find out what this is called. I believe this is called crystalline or crystal glaze, and something about there's a chemical that's put in one of the glazes that causes crystals to form in the glaze, and you know, potters and artists can create different designs based on that. I think this is so cool. What do you think of it? It's kind of a, I don't know what I would call it, a mauve maybe, with like a jade green color underneath, but these look like dandelions to me. I think this is very cool. please let me know what you think of it. Do you like it? Do you not like it? And I think this is just called a, I don't know what you call this shape. Teardrop, that's what I would call it. Yeah, just a little bud vase there. That's a good clarity there. Anyway, super cool, $1.99. And I saw this and I got this. I got this because I think I need something like this. I am of the generation that had everything on paper. And this is a Rolodex, probably from the 1980s. And yeah, it was $3.99, but Rolodex can be expensive. There is a resale value to this. So I don't know if I'm gonna resell it or keep it. It's in excellent condition. I think this was the most expensive thing I bought. Yeah, so I bought that. And, oh, this I didn't, did I buy this there? Yes, I did. And this little tin, I've heard that these little guys are collectible. This is obviously a little Scotsman. These are biscuit tins. This one was $3.99. This one, it says best before, it's upside down, but it says best before January 2013. So it probably came out Christmas time 2012. So, you know, that was 10 years ago. And I forget what the name of the company is, but you can look these up online. They're little biscuit tins. I can't remember the company that made them. But yeah, there's his little castle in his head. It should be more toward the front, but anyway, he's in great condition. There wasn't a thing wrong with him. So I don't know, maybe I'll sell him. Maybe I'll give him away. He's kind of cute. My husband is Scottish and I got a little bit of Scott in me as well. So maybe we'll just hang on to him. And look at my Jack. Isn't he awesome? You can see that I collect these. There's one off back there in the other room by my dog. There's one, a vintage one over there. They're all vintage, but some are older than others. So this guy's probably from the 1960s. His marking is long melted away, but I believe that he's a Renzi, which I think that's right, R-E-N-Z-I. Yeah, he's an older one. And he's got the narrow, you know, opening at the top and the wide handle and even a little bit of a lip up there, which you don't see very often. And he's just so cool. He's larger than some of the ones that are out today, than some of my 1980s ones back here. A lot of these are from the 80s. But yeah, isn't he cool? $1.99. So I was so happy to have him. Seems the only blow molds I can find are jack-o'-lantern pails. So I'll take it. And then at the Discovery Shop, where I just went in for a minute, I found this can opener. Did I find that at the Discovery Shop? Yeah, for $2. And this is Ye Old Swing Away, and they just don't make them. You can still find Swing Away, I believe, but this one was made in the USA. They're hard to find made in the USA anymore. I don't know if this one had a year, but I would guess that this one is from the 1980s. Yeah, and it's really cool. So I don't know what I'm gonna do with that. I'll probably just keep it. these are the best can openers. You can have your electric can openers all you want. I will take a Swing Away any day. And it was $2, as you can see there. And on the weekend, I went into the charity shop that I like to go to when my cousin's here on the other side of town, but I wasn't in there very long. I might have even gone in there on a weekday. I got these two Pyrex casserole lids for 70 C's, which are hard to find. Any of the Pyrex casserole lids like this, I pick up, because when I find those Pyrex casseroles, they often need a lid. And I can see there's a tiny little chip on one end, but it doesn't usually matter because people want those lids. And these were actually in pretty good condition and 50 cents each. How could I go wrong with that? I cannot leave these cute little doll pillowcases for $1.50 each, or at least this one was. You can see there's a little embroidered lamb on there, sweet little lace edging. They're just small pillowcases, as you can see there. So for a child's bed or crib or a doll. And then this one, this was the edging, but it also had a little lamb in the corner here. Look how cute that is. And they were really in excellent condition, very clean. They were probably just in someone's, you know, cedar chest, $1.50. And this was too beautiful to pass up. It does have some stains. This is a beautiful table runner. I have a notion to keep it for myself if I don't give it away. And it said, as is $1, but I have some magic tricks for getting out stains in linens that I've learned from the doll world. Here's one. Look how beautiful this is with this kind of deco detailing. I just think it's beautiful. You can see this is like almost like a little ring here. Anyway, I have some little tricks and washes that are good at getting out stains, but what do you want for a dollar? So this is probably the more prominent stain, and I'll see if I can get that out. If not, I don't know what I'll do with it, but it is just beautiful. I'll probably use it anyway because those things don't bother me too much. It's gorgeous, it really is. Well, I hope you enjoyed seeing these things. I have just a quick little bunch of things I got at Goodwill, but I'll make just a short little video for that so I don't take up too much of your time. I hope you enjoyed this quick little haul. I will be back on the 1st for the giveaway. I don't know what I'm giving away yet. And I was hoping to do an animation for the dolls Halloween party, but I probably won't be able to. I just won't have time. But I will show you the little bit of decorating I've done in the doll's house. They're having a little Halloween party, and I want to share with you some little things that I made and how I displayed them. So thanks for stopping by to see my little haul, and come back in a few minutes or a few days, and I'll show you what I got at the Goodwill. Have a great day. I could not leave these little doll pillowcases at $1 each. Is it $1 or $1.50? $1.50. What? I can't see anything.